Last month, the Federal Reserve released a financial stability report at the end of November 2019, and I wouldn't have even found out about it if not for the podcast that Wolf Richter at wolfstreet.com is doing. So shout out to Wolf if he listens to my podcast. But he talked briefly about the financial stability report, and the Fed now joins the Bank of Japan, the European Central Bank, and others. And the Fed has been doing the financial stability report, but I just recently found it. But these central banks, whether it's the Bank of Japan, the European Central Bank, and of course now the Federal Reserve, are giving us warnings. We just need to know where to look. Now, they're not going to announce all the largest warnings, all the big red flags, but buried in their research reports, as I've talked about in July with their research report on collateralized loan obligations, in the Fed's financial stability report from November 2019, there are warning signs. So as you can see here on your screen, the Fed is warning about asset price valuations. They have sections on it. They're also talking about warnings about the business private sector credit. And if you go to the next slide here, you can see that the amount of leverage loans, according to the Fed's own research, the growth has exploded. It has by far, other than student loan debt, which has been growing according to the Fed's research at 9.3% average annual growth since 1997 to the second quarter of 2019, 9.3% growth is enormous. But the largest growth by far on that chart, and I had to take out mortgages there to fit the financial stability report because I was debating putting that background in and doing a live stream show. Now I moved it here to a short video to show this chart so it's easier to read. But the amount of leveraged loans, the percentage growth in just the last 12 months from the second quarter 2018 to the second quarter 2019, 14.6%. So they're still growing very, very rapidly. And the leveraged loans are what goes into the collateralized loan obligations. So this is the toxic sausage, and it's basically just different degrees of bad. And since 1997, leveraged loans have grown at a 15.4% pace up to the second quarter of this year. And finally, in this last chart here, Gordon T. Long made this chart, his firm did, about understanding what a collateralized loan obligation or CLO is. And you could take a look here, and this explains it. This is set up very similarly to how mortgage-backed securities were, and this could be what is causing some of the problems in the repo market. Now, we don't know if the Fed is actually taking collateralized loan obligations. That Japanese banks bought a lot of collateralized loan obligations. They are some of the largest owners because the Bank of Japan has been warning about it for the last couple months that Japanese banks own too many CLOs. And particularly, they named a couple large Japanese banks. And this goes back to financial repression with these central banks, all these central banks manipulating interest rates lower. So banks and insurance companies and pension funds were desperate for income, desperate for yield. So they gambled on these CLOs. Now, these CLOs have not collapsed yet, but these are ticking time bombs. The game of musical chairs, the game of hot potato will end just like it did for mortgage-backed securities. And these CLOs, which are currently the leveraged loans that are going into the CLOs, are being downgraded now, a lot of them. Massive amounts of downgrade, and eventually they will start to collapse and default, and then that will send reverberations through the tranche screen you see there on the right. So I just wanted to do this short video. I will attach links to the Fed's financial stability report from November 2019 if you want to take a look for yourself, but it goes over a number of different things it sees in the economy, and some of the biggest red flags the Fed sees are in corporate credit, corporate bonds, high yielding debt, and of course, leveraged loans, which is what goes the toxic sausage that goes into the collateralized loan obligations or CLOs.